Today we are at the factory in Racine, Wisconsin called Modine. Or Modine. Let's see, I gotta find where I'm parking. Apparently they manufacture the chiller for the Tesla Model S. Help keep your battery and all your electronics nice and cool. We're going to be meeting, I believe, the CEO and let's see, who else? CEO, oh shoot, and the Milwaukee Business Times newspaper. We're going to be doing some photo shoots of the Model S, and not much to see out here, but cool stuff, hey? All right, I'll update you guys later. I'm inside Modine's lobby. They're just displaying some of their products here. Got a mock-up of a cooling system. It's kind of neat. Cooling system pancake. Obviously, this is probably for a big rig. Lots of awards on the wall inside, but I don't think I can film in there, so. All right, I'll update you guys in a bit. So, just left the Modine manufacturing facility. Actually, they don't manufacture anything at that facility anymore. The one in Racine, Wisconsin, apparently is where they do the testing of all their parts, wind tunnels, whatnot. I did not have a chance to visit their wind tunnels this trip, although they did offer. However, we were invited to come back at a later date and go for a little tour, which I will take them up on that. We were working with Joel, and let me make sure I don't screw up his last name, Casterson. Joel Casterson is the engineering director, Engine Products Group, and awesome guy. Showed us the breakdown of the modules for the Tesla Model S, and a brief explanation of how they worked. Also asked my opinion, got some feedback on, or gave him some feedback on, you know, what noise level and performance of it so far. Apparently it's keeping the Model S batteries nice and cool, and it's working pretty darn good, at least in my opinion. Apparently the modules were designed for the Performance 85, P85 version of the Model S. It's the same module in all versions of the Model S. Like I said, it was designed for the P85 to remove the heat from that. So that means it's actually slightly overkill for the lesser model. So while it's good enough for him, it's made for her. Okay, that's a bad deodorant stick commercial knockoff. So if it's good enough for the P85, it's even better for the standard 85 and standard 60 kilowatt battery. You'll probably get a little better cooling, which in my opinion would mean you can floor it more without hitting your temperature limiter, which would be why on my MS60 I was able to floor it to 120 a number of times in a row without hitting that cutoff, while on the P85 and P85 Plus. I was only able to floor it a couple times, although it did cool down rather quickly. It only took about 15-20 seconds to get the temperature back down to what we need to be able to floor it. I'm talking about flooring it from a dead stop. That's a lot of power and a lot of amperage. 240 kilowatts on the standard 60, MS60, or I believe 320 on the Performance Plus and Performance model. So there you have it. This is the end of this actual video. I've pieced together a number of clips just to make one larger video. I hope you guys enjoyed some of the photographs. We had a blast making them. Had a lot of people from the factory coming, or not the factory, the facility, coming to look at what was going on, you know, as they're leaving for home. It looks like I am not going to make it home or back to my shop today, so might as well go home, the 30 miles home, grab the kids, and go to Gurnee, Illinois. Go enjoy the mall a little bit, cool down, as it's unseasonably hot today. This is the 20th, or is this the 19th of September, and it is currently 82 degrees and humid. This is actually supposed to be like July weather, whereas last year this day, I think we were at 42 with a chance of snow. Crazy, huh? So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Shout out to TeslaMotorsClub.com and Elon, thank you for the awesome car once again. We're hopping the freeway now, but thank you for the awesome car. And I will say, I don't believe you visited this factory personally, but I will say you chose, or no, I keep saying factory, it's not a factory, but this company's world headquarters, I should say, and testing facility. But you chose a very good company to whose basket you're putting your eggs in. Although, Elon, your eggs are pretty much made out of titanium and indestructible at this point. You chose a very good company, and once again, I applaud you and your team with the decisions they made. And I know they were hoping that you'd be able to stop by them on your cross-country road trip, and wouldn't be a waste of time. And I know there'd be a lot of people that would love to see you visit southeastern Wisconsin. Be awesome. I know people would love to see you visit everywhere, but it's probably not possible. And here I'm rambling again. Oh yeah, Elon, apparently my brother-in-law named his kid after you. So, kudos to that. You're earning yourself a reputation. Definitely got yourself a reputation going, man. Enjoy, and I think I should just stop the video now and worry about driving, as I'm getting a lot of thumbs up and waves at the moment. And I think I'm going about 30 miles over the speed limit. Cheers!